हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू आवर चैनल ब्रेन अलाइव। वी विल स्टडी कंटिन्यूटी इक्वेशन इन दिस वीडियो। कंटिन्यूटी इक्वेशन इन सेमीकंडक्टर्स। व्हाट इज कंटिन्यूटी इक्वेशन? कंटिन्यूटी इक्वेशन इज अ फंक्शन ऑफ स्पेस एंड टाइम। इट टेक्स इनटू अकाउंट ऑल द प्रोसेसेस दैट अफेक्ट्स द करियर कंसंट्रेशन इन सेमीकंडक्टर, एंड दीज प्रोसेसेस आर जनरेशन एंड रिकम्बिनेशन। जनरेशन कैन बी ऑफ टू टाइप्स। One is due to thermal energy and the other is due to external source, say application of light. So generation and recombination affect the concentration of charge carriers. In case of recombination, in a particular volume of semiconductor, it decreases the concentration of charge carriers and generation increases it. So we add on the things that increases the carrier concentration and we minus or subtract the things that decreases the carrier concentration in a semiconductor. So we will add generation and subtract recombination, and then we will consider drift and diffusion current. Let's take a p-type semiconductor. In this semiconductor, we will consider only this area, this particular slice of this semiconductor bar. In this particular slice, from point X to point delta X, X plus delta X, this is the length of this particular slice. Whole concentration changes due to generation and recombination. Generation takes place when electrons from the valence band jump to the conduction band. So number of carriers or number of holes increases in this particular area. And recombination takes place when electron from the conduction band falls back to the valence band. So electron and hole pair disappears and hole concentration decreases. So generation and recombination affects hole concentration in this particular volume. So we can write change in hole concentration with respect to time in this particular volume equals to generation number of holes, generation of number of holes in this volume minus recombination of holes in this particular volume. So this is due to generation and recombination. Now we will consider inflow of charge carriers, inflow of holes in this particular slice at point X. So we can write the holes entering into this particular slice. We can write JPX, this is also a function of X space, into cross-sectional area upon charge on these holes. So this is the number of holes entering into this slice. Now we will subtract the number of holes that are leaving this particular slice. So number of holes leaving at X plus del X. So JPX plus del X into cross-sectional area upon charge. So this particular equation, this equation is the complete equation, continuity equation. And now what left? Thus just simplification of this equation. Now we'll show you this particular term is number of holes with respect to time, and this is particular term is number of holes generated, and this is number of holes recombined, and this is number of holes flowing into the slice, and this term is number of holes flowing out from the slice. Now we will just simplify this particular equation. Now del P upon del T delta V equals to G del V minus recombination rate del V plus JPX A. We will multiply del X in numerator and denominator. This becomes this minus JPX plus del X into A into del X upon Q into del X. Now The term delta V G delta V minus R delta V plus JP X, this becomes delta V upon Q delta X minus JP X plus del X, this is also delta V upon Q into DX. Now the term delta V, this is also this side and each term has delta V, so this cancels out. Now what left is generation minus recombination plus, now we'll take the negative sign, minus 1 upon Q, we'll write this first, JP X plus del X upon DX minus, now this term JP X. We know this term is nothing but this is definition of derivative. This is definition of derivative. So we can write del P upon del T equals to generation minus recombination minus 1 upon Q. And this is derivative, so it becomes del P upon del X. This is the continuity equation for Hall's. Similarly, we can write continuity equation for electrons. We will replace number of Hall's by n number of electrons. This is now becomes del N upon del T, del N upon del X. This is for electrons. Now we know G is increase in Hall concentration per second. And this G is equals to G naught plus GL. This G naught is generation of electrons or Hall's at thermal equilibrium. Plus this GL is generation of electron Hall pair due to the application of light. Now this R is decrease in Hall concentration per second, so this is equals to recombination rate at equilibrium plus change in Hall concentration. This P is Hall concentration after the application of external field, say light, minus this is equilibrium concentration upon this is life mean lifetime of Halls, means for what time the number of Halls remain in this particular slice. So this is del P upon tau P. So R can be written as R naught plus del P upon tau P. But we know G naught equals to R naught, means at equilibrium generation is equal to the equilibrium recombination. So this will be cancelled out. So G minus R equals to GL minus del P upon tau P. So we can put G minus R equals to this term. So the Hall current can be written as Hall current equals to Hall, this is Hall current density, drift current density plus diffusion current density, and this will be equal to charge on n p number of Halls, this is the number of Halls, into this is mobility of Halls and this is applied electric field, minus this is diffusion current density, this is q is charge on Halls and this is the diffusion coefficient dp, and this is del p upon del x. So this is total current density. Now we will put the value of JP. This is the value of JP in this equation that we have derived earlier for Halls. This G minus R is also replaced by GL minus del P upon tau P. This is also derived earlier. Now we will put the value of JP here. Now the equation becomes 1 upon Q del upon DX, and this is the value of JP. Now we will take the derivative. The equation now becomes डेल पी अपॉन डेल टी इक्वल्स टू जी पी माइनस डेल पी अपॉन टाओ पी. दिस एल इज रिप्लेस्ड बाय पी बिकॉज वी आर कैलकुलेटिंग नंबर ऑफ होल्स इन दैट पर्टिकुलर स्लाइस. सो वी विल रिप्लेस दिस एल फॉर लाइट बाय पी, वी मीन्स होल्स. नाउ वील टेक द डेरिवेटिव ऑफ दिस टर्म. वी विल टेक दिस टर्म फर्स्ट. दिस बिकम्स डेल स्क्वायर पी अपॉन डेल स्क्वायर डेल एक्स स्क्वायर डी पी. दिस इज फॉर डिफ्यूजन कंपोनेंट. एंड वी विल टेक द पार्शियल डेरिवेटिव ऑफ दिस टर्म बिकॉज पी एंड ई आर द फंक्शंस ऑफ स्पेस मीन्स एक्स. द पार्शियल डेरिवेटिव ऑफ दिस इज माइनस म्यू पी डेल ई अपॉन डेल एक्स पी माइनस म्यू पी ई डेल पी अपॉन डेल एक्स. दिस कंपोनेंट इज ड्यू टू ड्रिफ्ट. सो दिस इज ड्रिफ्ट कंपोनेंट, दिस इज डिफ्यूजन कंपोनेंट, एंड दिस कंपोनेंट इज ड्यू टू रिकम्बिनेशन ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन एंड होल, एंड दिस कंपोनेंट इज ड्यू टू जनरेशन ऑफ होल्स. सो दिस इज द कंप्लीट कॉन्टिन्यूटी इक्वेशन फॉर होल्स. नाउ वी कैन ऑल्सो राइट द कंप्लीट कॉन्टिन्यूटी इक्वेशन फॉर इलेक्ट्रॉन्स. दिस इक्वेशन इज ए कंप्लीट कॉन्टिन्यूटी इक्वेशन फॉर इलेक्ट्रॉन्स. हेयर द साइंस आर पॉजिटिव बिकॉज इक्वेशन फॉर इलेक्ट्रॉन्स हैज पॉजिटिव साइंस. वन अपॉन क्यू इज दिस टर्म इज पॉजिटिव हेयर. एंड ऑल्सो ड्रिफ्ट एंड डिफ्यूजन करंट. And for drift and diffusion current here for electron it has positive sign. Though so all signs in these terms are positive. Only this sign is negative. So this is a complete continuity equation for electrons. I hope you understand the concept clearly. If you like the video please hit the like button and subscribe the channel. Thanks for watching the video.